Painting on a surface like Masonite or painting on canvas, it's like you could paint on anything. You could paint on rags if you want to, or dish rags stretched. The thing that makes this so beautiful is this beautiful glowing effect. And one of the reasons why I love the masterpiece canvases when we get into larger canvases is because it is sealed, you know, and you can seal your paintings and do all of that stuff. But the masterpiece canvas has that for you. The thing that I feel about canvases is you don't need to buy canvases until you're up at 16 by 20, 18 by 24. Because realistically, anything bigger than that is too heavy. So this board, 18 by 24, 20 by 24, it fit with a frame, the entire art piece becomes heavy and big, okay? As we get smaller into our paintings, I would probably say painting on Masonite boards is a much smarter idea than painting on canvas. And one of the reasons is because, you know, when you take a photograph and put it onto your computer and you blow it up, you get all the pixels. And then when you bring it back down to its normal size, it looks normal. Well, what happens with canvas is that small canvases have the same amount of texture to it as big canvases do in a small section. So you end up doing a portrait on a small canvas with all of this texture. She looks like she's got acne. You know, the person looks like they have acne because the canvas itself is porous. And the problem is with the porous is that every one of those holes reflects light. I mean, absorbs light. So you don't get this wonderful shiny effect. When you look at the paintings in the museums that glow, most of those paintings, like the Mona Lisa, are done on wood panels. And one of the reasons for that is that you have a flat surface there that reflects light.
But how do you get the paint to stick to it?
It takes a little bit of practice, and you kind of have to play with it. It's part of the practice. Remember how I said you have to do a lot of them, and eventually you get used to it. Now, I recommend anything smaller than 16 by 20 to go to a board. And I even go further by saying don't go to a canvas-covered board because you're basically buying into the same problem that you're having, is the textures. Unless you want to spend most of your life sanding that canvas down. So yeah, that's why it illuminates so much. But I would recommend going down, picking up Masonite, cutting it up into fours or tens or whatever the hardware store will do for you, 6x10s, 8x20, you know, the cheapest product you possibly do, and then go get Rust-Oleum primer. Mm-hmm. Don't use gesso. Yeah. Gesso is a pain in the ass, and it's also an acrylic-based thing that you end up having big goopy globs that you have to sand. You can just take the spray primer. Now, they put that spray primer on the outside of buildings before you paint them, or metal, you know, gutters. Your painting will never be subjected to what your metal gutter is subjected to. So as far as permanency, probably more permanent than gesso. If you did the same thing with gesso in a few years, that would flake off, not that primer. Go give it some really good coats, and remember the reason why you're putting the primer on is to make the surface so that it doesn't absorb the oils. So you have to put a fair amount of primer on top of it. And don't sand it. If you sand it, it becomes really glassy. Yeah. But unsanded is better than a canvased surface. So yeah, you get better colors that way. Yes.
$44 for a sheet of Masonite, and they cut it up for me. But one of them that was, I can't remember what it was supposed, 16 by 20, and then have me take my jigsaw and saw this much off the side because it was actually not.
They're not precise when you ask them to do it. I had to do mine all over again.
Well, yeah, but see, when you did them all over again, you made sure. There's a lot of idiots that work in, you know, the lumber industry. And so you have to find one of those idiots that, I know, some of them are really smart, intelligent people, but a lot of them are just one step up from minimum wage, and they just learn to work this off. I mean, you have to go, okay, figure what an 8-foot sheet is, and then make sure that they cut that down to the correct size. And then you take a ruler and go, that's 7.5, not 8. Oh yeah, no, they will.
Okay.
You can get them to cut it. That's what you're paying for. You pay $5 a cut. And you can sit there and go, it has to be that. Yeah. And they can do it. They're just lazy.
I think mine was $44, no matter if I cut or not.
Well, there you go. Every lumber place will be different. And if you're getting free cuts, you shouldn't complain. But if you're paying for it, and then you can always do this. You can go, hey, dude. Usually it's a guy that's running it, but you could say it to the guy, go, hey, look, make sure these are exactly correct and there's a 10 buck tip for you in your pocket afterwards. You know, and they'll do it, you know.
Also, the Rust-Oleum cans clog up after the first use, and I had a heck of a time getting it not to spit at the canvas.
Well, what you do is you do all of your priming all in one time. So, and the thing too, is that this is not a, but if you have the Rust-Oleum can, one way to prevent, when you are done, yeah.
Turn it upside down.
When you're done spraying, you turn it upside down like this and keep spraying. And that will take the paint out of the, and I never have a problem with that. You do that with your varnishes too.
You store it that way?
No, and then you store it this way. But basically what you're doing is you're taking the, you're cleaning, because that, they had, there's a little tube that goes to the bottom of this. And you turn it upside down, there's still a lot of pressure, and then what it does is clean out the thing. So, and it keeps your, and then turn it back up, store it. See what you learn in this class?
Still learning.
I mean, those are like basic things. Tip your guys, clean out your thing. And this is like a hardware class. Anyway, everybody likes money. But anyway, good point though. It is beautiful because of the surface. You want to improve your surfaces? Just paint on Masonite boards. The cheapest. The cheapest board. You will love them. And they glow. They look different.
Where do they sell?
All over.
Well, like San Jose Lumber, whatever.
Southern
Lumber.
Southern Lumber.
And they sell them at Home Depot. And you don't even have to buy a whole sheet. They even sell 24 by 36 sheets.
Pine yeah. Cone Lumber.
And then you've got the petroleum.
Pine Cone Lumber. Rust-Oleum primer.
Out of,
at the hardware store.
Yeah. I didn't spray.
You have to spray them because the oil will absorb into the chipboard. And so it's not Masonite, it's chipboard. If you it will soak up in there, and you actually are setting yourself up for canvas rot. Yeah, so that you don't want the oil in that wood base, just like you don't want oil in your paper.
I painted on straight on mine.
Yeah. Oh, that's good. If it works, it works. Mm-hmm.